David Morris Studio. I'm pleased to be joined by Brian Jules of the Toronto Argonauts. So, Brian, first question, you got new number. You were number six last year. Marcus Ball comes back for his first team at the Argos. So was there any exchange involved with getting that number off of you?
Not really. I mean, Marcus owes me a steak dinner, but we talked about that and laughed together. You know, he's a good friend of mine, and, you know, we got a bigger picture right now, and, you know, it honestly comes down to just preference and everything. So I'm glad it worked out for all of us, and you know, I got 10 more reasons to be better this year. So
so obviously this team is looking to do a big reset after last season. They bring in some veteran guys, one of those guys SJ Green. Growing up, you ever watch SJ play in Montreal? I know you're from the eastern part of Canada. What does it mean to have a guy like that in camp to work with you as you're getting ready for your second season?
Well, I mean, you said it exactly. You know, SJ's a true veteran. You know, he's been in this league for a while now, and, you know, the old man still got some juice. And, you know, my first real recollection and memory of SJ was actually, I believe it was the Grey Cup rematch back in 2009 or something, where he was between the Owls and Saskatchewan, where he made that outstanding one-handed catch in the end zone in overtime to win the game. So that was the almighty AC throwing that Anthony Calvillo. So you know, he brings a lot to the table. You know, he's a good vet. He holds us in check and keeps us guys up. And you know, we're obviously really happy to have him. And you know, he's looking good out there, like typical SJ.
Another veteran guy here on the team that the Argos will need to have a good season, Ricky Ray. You had some work with Ricky last season. You start off on the special teams. Now you started. What was it like to work with Ricky, and how good does it feel to have him back?
Well, I mean, like any time you get a first ballot Hall of Famer back on your team, you know, Ricky's what you would say is the gold standard for what being a professional is. You know, he comes to work with his lunch pail, puts the hours in, and really sets the tone for us young guys in terms of preparation for each week. You know, and Ricky still got it. You know, he still slings the ball like he did when he was. You know, he's got some little bit of. Little age to him now, but you know, he still slings a rock. You know, he's one of the best of all times, and you know, we're extremely happy to have him, and I think this is going to be a good season for having Captain Rick back.
How did you find your season when you start off special teams and you obviously became a starter?
Yep.
How did you find that allowed you to make that quick transition? I know it's not easy for a first year guy in the CFL to do that.
Yeah, well, I mean, special teams is a great way to kind of get yourself as a young player on the field, kind of get adjusted to the game and kind of get those nerves out. You know, for me, it's still that little bit of nervous when you get your first start. And, you know, I think I handled myself pretty well when I got in and did the right things and, you know, made some good plays. You know, it's just really coming down to being in your playbook and know what your assignment is and doing it week in, week out.
What's your big expectation for yourself this season? Obviously, there's a lot of guys on the team. There's a lot of competition in camp, especially with the Canadian side. So what are you looking at to improve on this season?
This season, you never be perfect at what you do. And, you know, I got a lot of work. You know, the big thing about being a receiver and young like myself is, you know, you have to stay humble. You know, I don't think that even, you know, when I get into my eighth or ninth year, if I make it that far, I'll never be satisfied with what I am as a player. And, you know, there's always things that you can work on. And, you know, I think even SJ would be the first one to say that about that. And he's kind of a guy that keeps us in check and continues to work on it. And, you know, he's giving me tips left, right, and center all the time. So I think that's basically what I want to bring to the table is just bring everything better what I did last year.
So obviously new head coach, new GM, but not a very different scheme as to what Milanovic had last year. Is it very similar?
Yeah, well, I mean, like you said, exactly. Milanovic was a product of Mark Trestman's offense, and now we just have the OG running it. So, you know, Mark's very meticulous with detail, and he's been very good with us and with me, and so we're extremely happy to have him. You know, he's a very decorated coach with a lot of pedigree, so I'm very excited for this season for sure.
Your combine last year was really known for your fit. Like you brought yourself out in the combine. What allows you to be successful with your size. I mean, CFL is, sometimes people say it's a speed game. Receivers, some big receivers have success. Are you trying to get like a mix of both, or what allows you to be successful there?
I think for me, like you said, you know, I bring a lot of different things to the table. You know, I'm a tall receiver, but I can get in and out of my breaks when I use the right footwork. So, you know, just for me, it's like you said, it's big for me to be explosive, because I don't think there's any other player in the league that really kind of embodies what my body type is. You know, I'm 6'4", 230 plus, and I can run pretty much all the routes. So, you know, I think that I bring a lot to the table in terms of what my physicality and what it is to be a receiver.
Last question: you got your degree this summer. How did it feel to get your degree after putting all the work in football and then having something else to come out of it?
Yeah, well, like you said, my 4 years. You know, you're a student athlete, and even when I finished my first year as a professional, I was still a student athlete. So, student pro athlete. So. Glad to look at Ian walking in front of the camera right there.
That happens, you know. Yeah. Kids want to have fun. I mean, it's Argos Day today.
Yeah, so. Exactly. No, we got a good crowd out here. I mean, look at all the people out here coming out supporting Argos Day. And back to your question, I think, I went back and got my degree. You know, it was one thing that I promised my mom that I would do was to go back and finish right away. So I'm officially a KD alumni. I put my KD alumni hat on, and I'll be watching in the Boys of Falls. So
Well, I won't keep you much longer. I know you want to get to the fans, so
absolutely.
Thank you very much, Brian.
I appreciate it.
We'll see you around the season.